Hey guys, what's going on? So I thought I'd make a video and talking about the types of videos that I like to watch on YouTube. Just to get it out of the way, I don't really watch any specific channels. I usually look for certain types of videos that I've always liked before. Now things that I don't know if you guys heard of it back in the 90s. There used to be a TV show called Unsolved Mysteries, where they did little investigations on mysteries that, you know, obviously were never solved. Things like murders, like missing people, UFO stories, even ghost stories. Another show that I used to like as well is Cold Case Files, America's Most Wanted. I like watching Ghost Adventures. It's a group of three guys who usually do investigations on areas that are normally haunted. They mostly go around the United States, but they've gone overseas. I think Venice was one location they went to. But that's another series also. That's pretty good. I also like to watch Brad Meltzer's Decoded series. As you can see, it's usually a lot of stuff with mystery and like ghosts. Just stuff with a lot of history to them, really. Now going on the list, I like watching also Conspiracy Theory with Jesse Ventura. What else? UFO stories. Also, to get some of my favorite shows out of the way, I really wanted to mention some of these. These are a few special episodes that I've watched that I've really liked. There was one called the D.B. Cooper Story, which is supposedly is the very first airplane hijacking, and the only one who actually managed to get away with it. I watched a couple of episodes from people that did their own investigation on it, so I can get different kinds of theories and evidence, and it is one really good story that I liked. Another one was the Boston City Strangler. Another one was the story of the Lady Ronkonkoma, or they also known her as Princess Ronkonkoma. That story is about some Native American Indian lady who was denied the love that she wanted with a foreigner. This is a very long time ago. So after she died, supposedly her spirit still stays around the lake where they used to meet. So she comes back and claims the life of a male. I forget how often, but it's something like that. I'm sure they have some videos you guys can check out or read up on it on Google as well. Another one actually is Executioner Rock's Lighthouse. Actually, moving on to government stories, there's actually a few of them that really caught my interest. Aside from the obvious ones like Area 51 and the Roswell incident, we all know about those ones. But I started to look up some other ones that really were not as well known. And one of them is the Plum Island Research Center. I believe this is off the coast of Long Island, close to New York. I believe it's somewhere there. So they were doing some research on that Plum Island, and they found out that people that do work there do actually do viral research, like creating viruses for like warfare for those kind of things. Another one that was really interesting was a government conspiracy about a station in Alaska called HAARP, which is called, it's spelled H-A-A-R-P. When I saw this one, I never heard of it, but when I saw the facility, it looked really interesting because the way they kind of set it up, because if you look at Alaska, they don't really have that many government stations that are really publicly well known, and this was one that was really well hidden. So when I came upon HAARP, I thought it was just like another military base, but there was something else really to it. It's not a military base at all. It's more like another research center. But the interesting thing about this one is they have like this really big kind of I forget how many square miles it is, but it's this really huge area where they have like a ton of electrical kind of antennas or or a raise or something. They have a lot of them. Really, you have to watch the video to check it out. I don't know if they're like antennas or just electrical rays or something, but they have a lot of them out in the field. Like, they're all grouped together, and there are people in the area have been saying there's been a couple of times when they see this huge beam of light that shoots into the sky. And so the group that was doing the research on HAARP found out that through people who used to work there or people that had family that used to work there, the whole idea of this kind of thing or this creation was to manipulate the weather and possibly use it for, you know, to benefit mankind. But since the military kind of took over it, I guess in a way the military can see it as a form of a weapon. So that is a really interesting story you guys might want to check out too. This other one was actually one that it actually caught me by surprise because I didn't think they were capable of doing this, but it just seems like they are. So the government has like a secret underwater base called Autech. Now it's located near Andros Island, which is near the Bermuda Triangle. Now the security level on this is kind of equal to Area 51. It's pretty high so that people, like the general public, cannot get in pretty much. The other thing is the only way you can have access is supposedly through an elevator shaft on the base that's on the land. But that's not the real interesting part. Is the interesting part is where the elevator goes. Now since it's already on land, there's nowhere to go up because there's no facility that's really high. So the only kind of conception is that it goes underground. And these guys, it was actually the UFO hunters who did this investigation on the Autech. So they sent out some guys into the ocean and into the sea, and they went underwater. And one guy claimed when he was diving one time, he saw this really long cable. It's a big cable line that actually extends from the mainland out under the ocean floor and to this very huge, like, crater that supposedly digs very deep into the sea level. So it's so really deep that they can't really dive down there. And the odd thing is, you see this cable line that stretches all the way from the mainland going underwater, and then it continues down into like this big abyss of like a huge crater in like the sea level, and you can't even see where it goes. It just like disappears into the abyss pretty much. So that one basically was reported by a couple people who have been living in the area, and they've been seeing kind of strange things in the water. So they came to their own kind of conception that they believe that UFOs might even be underwater, not exactly in the sky or in space all the time. So it is another thing to think about. So if you guys like mystery and things of a lot of history and stuff like that, you know, I did name a bunch of different articles or investigations by name, so you can check them out. I really like looking into a lot of this stuff, because I do like stuff that has a lot of mystery and kind of secrecy to it, so I thought, you know, why not? So I'm still looking about new stuff, because whenever I got some free time, I kind of like seeing new stuff I've never heard of, especially the HAARP project and the Autech one. I never heard of them. So anyways, if you guys got some interesting stories or articles or investigations you've seen, and you remember them by name, let me know, and I'd like to check out some of them, because I'm always into seeing some new ones, because I think they're really interesting. So anyways, I'm pretty much going to end off this video. I know I put pinball and like the board of nightmare kind of to match the theme in a way, but you know. So anyways, that is about it. So let me know, guys, and I'll see you later. Ha 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 ha!